Welcome to the first week of the new It's Magical Readathon. So like always, I'm going to weekly vlog the Magical Readathon. I did it for the Newts last year and I also did it for the Owls this year, so I'm going to try to do it for the Newts as well. So in case you haven't seen my TBR for the Newts, I'm going to link it in the description box and also in the card. And in case you don't want to watch the entire video, I need to take 3 subjects: Herbology, Potions and Care of Magical Creatures. And then I also want to do 2 different specialties: Dragon Tamer and Merpeople Linguistics. So basically these are all the books I need to read. So it's quite a lot of books, especially since I chose a lot of big books with a lot of pages. So actually last night I started reading The Secret History by Jonah Tartt. So far I'm in chapter 2 on page 46, but so far what I've read, I think I'm really going to enjoy this book. I don't want to give myself too high expectations, but I'm really liking her writing style and the story so far is captivating. I'm going to go to the supermarket right now. So I have some packages that I want to open. This is all skincare. So this is my second time buying all of these products. This is my current summer skincare routine. I also have some other products, but these are like the main things. I like this face wash. It doesn't strip away my natural oils and it doesn't leave my skin too greasy or too tight. This is the best moisturizer if you have combination prone acne skin. And lastly, this is the serum I'm using right now. I used to use the one from The Ordinary that everyone used. And the first time I used that, it worked for me. But then when I was using it during quarantine, my skin was breaking out so much that I have no idea if it was because of that. I started using this one and my skin has cleared up a lot. So right now it's making a lot of noise. So right now it's 10 a.m. I think, and today I've only slept 2 hours. I'm actually doing good. Like, I know I look kind of tired, I always do, to be honest. I'm leaving today for a month and someone is coming to my flat to take care of it, so I wanted to have everything cleaned and ready for them, and also need to pack. So I've spent all morning cleaning my dishes, doing laundry and just cleaning my room. And now I'm going to have some breakfast because I'm starving and I really want a coffee. Today's Monday, by the way. Happy Monday, everyone. So these are the books that I'm going to take with me. There's 4 physical books and then there's my Kindle as well. So far, I've only started reading these 2 books. This one, so far, I'm loving it. I'm on page 116 and what I've read so far, not a lot has happened, but the way that Tartt writes, I think it's very interesting and very captivating because she tells a story in a way that you want to hear the story, you don't get bored of every single detail she describes. Good morning, everyone. So today is Tuesday and right now I'm going to start reading A Midsummer's Night Dream. I'm going to try to read it in one sitting and then after lunch I'm going to go to the beach. So I just got back from the beach and I do have a lot of reading updates. So first of all, The Song of Achilles, I'm on page 63 on chapter 8. So far we've had a lot of rape scenes and obviously I fucking hate those and I hate how disgusting men are sometimes. But Madeline Miller thankfully writes those scenes in a way that are not too triggering. I do get triggered a lot whenever things like sexual assault are mentioned. Then I also finished A Midsummer Night Dream, and honestly it wasn't really my book. I got lost a lot. There were like 4 stories in one. It was an enjoyable read, it's just that I don't think I would reread it again. So right now I'm reading The Secret History, and something has finally happened. I was liking the book so far, but like I already said, nothing was really happening. It was just like a storytelling of every single character. But now something has happened, or is going to happen, and I'm really hooked in the story. I'm on chapter 4 on page 146. So it has taken a while for the plot to start going, but I have no idea why. I have a mind so far, like I have really been invested in the story so far. So honestly, I'm really, really enjoying Donna Tartt's writing. Like, I'm loving it so far. Hi, good morning. So right now it's like 9 a.m. I think, and I'm walking my dog. So today is going to be a very hot day. I can already feel it. Okay, so a little reading update. I have been reading a lot of The Secret History. I'm almost halfway through the book. I have no complaints about this book. The only complaint is that the chapters are way too long for me. So far, the last, I think, like 30 pages is them talking shit about Bunny, and I just find that kind of funny. Then The Son of Achilles is the book that I'm taking to the beach. I've read like 100 pages, I think, 87 pages. I'm on chapter 10, and also so far I'm loving this book. I'm loving every single book I'm reading right now. So far the book has focused a lot on Achilles and Patroclus' relationship, and I don't mind that because it's not like too cheesy. And comparing this book to Circe, I obviously prefer Circe so far, but I love Madeline Miller's writing. And there's a blurb right here that says that Miller's prose is more poetic than almost any translation of Homer, and I completely agree with this one. Then I also started reading The Song Rising by Samantha Shannon, and I'm liking the beginning of this book way more than the beginning of The Mind Order. With this saga, I loved the first book. The second book was kind of a fail for me, but this one so far, I think I've read like 80 pages. I'm really, really happy with everything so far. And then lastly, I still haven't read anything by Call Me By Your Name, but I'm going to go to the balcony and read this book right now. And once I finish one of these books, I'm going to start reading The Priory of an Orange Tree. You're standing on that book right now. I really need to get more into the epic fantasy mood, so I think hopefully The Song Rising will help me to get into that. So I just finished reading book 1 of The Secret History, and oh my lord. I mean, I already knew what was going to happen because on the prologue they tell you the end of book 1, but now I'm going to start reading book 2. Hopefully I won't fall asleep. Right now I'm on chapter 6, page 275 on book 2. And god, I cannot stop reading this book. It's so, so, so captivating. I want to know what happens.
Todas las noches sean noches de boda, que todas las noches.
tired. So I just went on a morning swim and now I'm going to start reading Midnight Sun because I wanted to leave that book for the end of the month, but I saw that it was very long, so I'm going to start reading it now. Hi, so I just got home and it's actually pretty late, but I just wanted to talk about Midnight Sun because I've been thinking about this all day. So something that I've realized, I really enjoy reading Twilight in Edward's point of view, because when I read it from Bella's point of view, it was very cringy because it was the most teenage angst thing ever, and Bella from the movie, it's pretty different from Bella from the books. And also Jessica in the books is a complete bitch. I don't want to call her a bitch, but she's not a great friend. But Jessica in the movies, at least as the way I saw it, she was actually a good friend, I guess. I don't know, like there's so many things I can compare it. When I read Twilight, I also compared so many things. But I'm enjoying so much more reading Twilight from Edward's point of view. So right now I'm going to bed and I will see you tomorrow. Bye, good night. Hi everyone, happy Sunday. So today I think I'm going to take it really slow because for the past week I've been doing things non-stop and today I want to just, you know, take it slow. So first of all, I want to say that this week they called me from the job interview I did and I got the job. I had to do 3 interviews but I got the job, so technically I don't start till the beginning of September, so I still have a few weeks of summer vacation. Yeah, I guess I'm officially a uni graduate and an adult. Nice. So I'm getting really bored with Midnight Sun because right now the plot is basically the love story between Edward and Bella, and I was enjoying reading about Edward's past with being a vampire and the entire Cullen family story of being vampires. But honestly, I don't need to hear them saying I love you every single time or being obsessed with each other. I'm not really into these romantic things, so it's kind of boring right now. But I have like, I think 200 pages left, so I'm going to try to push it. I've been reading non-stop this book, so hopefully I will be able to finish it tonight or tomorrow. Okay, so I read a little bit more and right now I'm in a chapter that I love because it's about Edward's past as a vampire. And that's the thing, the chapters about him or the Cullen clan being vampires, I love those chapters. And when he explains Bella some things about vampires, I love them. But then there's some chapters where it's like 100 pages of them being cheesy with one another. I'm like, no, please. So yeah, this book has some very good parts and then some parts that are not really for me. I know some people love those chapters, they're not really for me. It's really, really hot, so you can probably hear my fan on the background. I'm sorry, it's just way too hot to not have it on right now. So right now it's like 6 p.m. I think, and I want to go to the beach for the rest of the evening and night. So since I'm not going to read anymore today, I'm going to do a wrap up of this week. I only finished one book and it's A Midsummer's Night Dream by William Shakespeare. I like that play, but it's not really something I'm going to think about too much. Then I'm halfway through 4 books: Midnight Sun, Song of Achilles, The Secret History, and almost halfway through The Song Rising. And I'm also halfway through Call Me By Your Name. So far I'm really happy because I'm loving every single book that I'm reading, and whenever I do a readathon, there's at least 1 or 2 books that I need to push myself to read. Or honestly, in general, sometimes when you start reading a book, I just want to kind of DNF it, but I don't really like DNFing books. I kind of push myself to read it, but in this case I am really liking every single book, so I'm really happy with this readathon. Since I'm not home and I don't have Wi-Fi, I'm not spending any time watching series, movies or YouTube, so I have a lot of free time to just read or stare at the ocean or just, you know, go to the ocean and swim. So, you know, sometimes it's good to not have Wi-Fi and just be present, I guess. So I hope you guys liked the first week of the Magical Readathon, and I'll see you next week. Bye!
My name, it is Maria, a merchant's daughter fair, and I have left my parents.